الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. We begin by praising Allah, we praise Him, we seek His help and we ask for His forgiveness. We take refuge with Allah from the evil of ourselves and from the evil consequence of our evil actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, no one can misguide, and whomsoever Allah leaves to go astray, no one can guide. And I testify that Allah alone is worthy of worship and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His servant and His messenger. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, we want to talk about a very major sin, something that is truly destructive, something that is perhaps in some ways the worst sin of all. And maybe it's the worst sin of all because it's from this sin everything else comes. And if you have this quality in yourself, then you will not be able to achieve any good in Islam. And that is the sin of pride. That is the sin of pride. My dear brothers and sisters, pride, kibr, means that you have a very high opinion of yourself. You think you are really something. Pride, more specifically, has been defined by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as rejecting the truth when it comes to you and looking down upon people. Rejecting the truth when it comes to you and looking down upon people. We know that from when a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, O Messenger of Allah, I don't love that anyone should have more beautiful shoes than me. You see, this man, he liked to have the most beautiful shoes of anybody. If he would see anyone with nicer shoes than him, he would have to find something nicer. And he said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is this pride? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Allah is Jameel. Allah is beautiful. And He loves that which is beautiful. Pride is to reject the truth when it comes to you and to look down upon people. So that is the definition of pride. Pride in Islam does not mean loving beautiful things or having a nice car or wearing nice clothes. Those things are fine. They are the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as long as they are halal, they are lawful, and you obtain them in a halal way, and you don't waste by extravagant and by excess, well then, alhamdulillah, those things are something that could actually lead you to thank Allah, to praise Allah, to even be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the problem is not with those things. No, the problem is when you think you're better than others. You think perhaps because you have more power, or you have more authority, or you have more money, or you are better looking, or you are more intelligent. And you think that because you have those things, you think you're better. And then you look down upon others, and you have contempt towards them. And then even more dangerous than all of that, when the truth comes to you. And the truth primarily being, of course, the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed. When you find something is from Allah and His Messenger, when you find something is from the Deen of Islam, you reject it because of your pride, because of your belief, your misguided belief in yourself. So that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever has an atom's weight of pride, an atom's weight, brothers and sisters, whoever has an atom's weight worth of pride will never enter paradise. Whoever has an atom's weight of pride will never enter paradise. Because the opposite of pride is humility. And humility is one of the most important and one of the greatest virtues. It is through humility that we are able to learn and to appreciate and to understand. Without humility, you will never learn. Without humility, you will never be able to surrender yourself and to submit yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us look through our book here that we are reading from and going through, and let's see some of those verses of the Quran, and some other sayings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam about this very important topic of pride. Pride and arrogance. And one of the stories that is mentioned in the Quran is the story of Qarun. Qarun was a man about whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that just the keys for his treasure chest, he needed a strong body of men to carry, just the keys. But Qarun was very proud. He used to think and he used to claim that the wealth that he had was because of his knowledge. He said, I have this wealth because of my knowledge. And the other thing that he used to do is he used to trail his garments. And this is something the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us about. It was also true in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There were people there and it was their custom that they used to trail their lower garments. They used to trail their garments in the dust and in the dirt. And they used to do that out of pride, to show off, to make themselves look mighty and proud. So that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us, and he said that whoever trails their garment out of pride, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not look at them, and he will not forgive them, and he will not purify them on the day of judgment. And that whoever's lower garment is trailed out of pride, then their ankles are in the hellfire. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that the believer's garment is to below his knee, or halfway down his legs, or down to his ankle. But what is below that is in the fire. So brothers and sisters, let's be careful that we do not wear our clothes in a way or in a manner that is imitating those people who are proud. Similar to this, my dear brothers and sisters, is the warning of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And these things, by the way, are amongst the major sins. We should not take these things lightly. They are very, very important. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us that whoever wears a dress of fame, so whoever dresses in a way that they wish to be famous and well known through that dress, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will dress them with garments of fire on the day of judgment. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited us from eating with gold and silver implements or on gold and silver plates. All of these things are connected to this issue of pride, because eating from gold and silver is something that the proud and the arrogant and the tyrants do. So as Muslims, we should keep ourselves far away from that type of behavior. And if one happens to have a position of power or authority, similarly, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will contend with the person who calls themselves King of Kings, for example. Malikul Mulk, the King of the Kings. And on the Day of Judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, I am the King of Kings. Who called himself by this title in this world? And all of this is concerning arrogance. Arrogance and pride, which we should be very, very far away from. And brothers and sisters, one of the worst type of arrogance and the worst type of pride is the arrogance and the pride that comes with knowledge. The most arrogant and the most proud of the people are those people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed with knowledge, knowledge of the deen. And yet they look down on people and they think they are mighty and they think they are high, and they are disappointed when people don't acknowledge them and respect them and revere them, and people who question them. So this is not knowledge. Knowledge, true knowledge, makes a person humble. When someone truly studies the deen and they have true knowledge, then they are humble. Because studying the Quran and studying the religion of Islam is something that makes you feel humble. It really makes you feel and makes you understand how small and insignificant you are before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this, my brothers and sisters, this pride is the sin of shaitan. Some scholars even said it was the first sin. Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to all the angels, bow down before Adam, they all bowed down except Iblis. And why was it that Iblis refused, Shaitan refused to bow down? That is because of his pride, his false pride. He claimed, he thought, I am better than him. This was his thinking. You made me from smokeless fire and you made him from the clay. So Shaitan was thinking he was better because of what he was made from. And this is very similar to the attitude of racists. There are some people who think that they are better than others because of the color of their skin. They think that a white man is superior to a black man, or an Arab is superior to a non-Arab. And these people are suffering from the same type of delusion and misguidance and arrogance and pride that Shaitan suffered from. The pride of our ancestors and boasting about our ancestors, the type of tribal pride as well, which is a false type of pride, where that leads us into not only being proud in the sense that I love the land that I was born in, I love my family, no, but it's a false type of pride, the pride that leads us to support our people in wrongdoing. This is something the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us about very severely, that whoever calls to tribalism and whoever fights for tribalism and whoever dies for tribalism, then they call and they fight and they die the death of Jahiliyyah. That is the death of ignorance of the people outside before the time of Islam, because Islam has come to eradicate all these false types of pride. And we talked about the importance of Hajj, brothers and sisters. We talked about when in Hajj, one of the things that we learn is humility. That when we are all dressed in those two pieces of cloth, we are all standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't know who you are next to. The person may be rich, may be poor, may be what you can't imagine, what their background is, or the respect they have or they don't have in front of others. But none of that is important, because in reality, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is looking at our hearts. So Iblis refused to prostrate to Adam, and that was due to his pride. And that pride therefore led him to destruction. So my brothers and sisters, we should be very, very careful. And also, pride is something really that is the exclusive domain of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, greatness is my garment and majestic pride is my cloak. If anyone competes with me, for them I will throw them in the fire. This is in Sahih Muslim. And also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that the hellfire and the paradise had a dispute, they had an argument. And the garden said, the paradise said, he said, no one will enter me except the weak among the people and their discarded ones. And the hellfire said, and I will punish, I will be the means through which the tyrant and the arrogant people will be punished. So the hellfire boasted that it was the place where the tyrants and the arrogant people will be boasted. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us away from that. Also, brothers and sisters, let us look to the beautiful advice that Luqman gave his son. Luqman was a wise man. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Luqman the beautiful advice that he gave his son. And turn not your face away from men with pride, nor walk in insolence through the earth. Verily, Allah does not like any arrogant boaster. And be moderate in your walking and your speech. Verily, the harshest of all voices is the braying of the ass. So let's look to this advice that Luqman gave to his son and break it down into component bits. First of all, he says, and don't turn your face away from men with pride. So what does this mean? You know, when people come to you, don't turn away from them, speak down to them, look down upon them as if they are nothing. Perhaps you even ignore them, look at them contemptuously. None of this is the right type of manner for a believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is not the right way for one person to treat another person. So don't be arrogant, looking down on people in an arrogant way. Rather be gentle, be kind, be soft, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he taught us through his own beautiful example that he was so kind and he was so gentle and he was so soft and forgiving to people. Also, we should not be boastful and arrogant and proud and stubborn. Don't do that, my brothers and sisters, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala certainly will hate you. And when you walk, walk in a moderate manner. You can't reach the mountains in height. Do you think you can cleave the earth asunder with your walk? Be humble with your walk. Don't be arrogant in the way that you walk and in the manner that you are. So also, on the other hand, you shouldn't be lazy and slouching around, but meaning you should be of a moderate pace. This is what Luqman advised his son. And when you speak, you should not shout at people and you should not raise your voice unnecessarily. Of course, there may be times when you need to do that, but in general, that is not how you should behave. So my brothers and sisters, we looked at this topic of pride from the point of view of the Quran and the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is full of beautiful examples of his kindness and his humility. And that does not mean that there is not a time and a place to admonish people, or even sometimes occasionally to be harsh if that is needed in order to correct someone at a certain time and certain place. So that is permissible. But as we said, arrogance and pride means to look down upon other people and reject the truth when it comes to you. Now, these are our two opposites, humility and pride. And what I want to do now is look at some of the statements from the other religions. For example, the Bible. And let's see, because that's one of the things we were going to do. We're going to look at other religions and to see what they had to say about the particular topic. Now, certainly pride is one of the cardinal sins. We mentioned that. It's considered to be one of those sins from which many, many, many other sins come from. So this issue of pride is considered to be a cardinal sin. And it's defined as an overblown sense of one's own worth and power, or an arrogant and swaggering attitude. And we can find some quotations, for example, in Proverbs, verses 18 to 19. Pride goes before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall. It is better to be of humble spirit with the lowly. This is a well-known saying. Pride comes before a fall. If you are lofty and you are proud, then surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's going to bring you down and He is going to humiliate you. And some of the statements in the Old Testament, for example, why are dust and ashes proud? Even during man's life, his body decays. In Isaiah, for example, human pride will be abased, the arrogance of men will be brought low, and the Lord alone will be exalted on that day. The idols will perish forever. So these are some of the statements concerning pride. Because in reality, the only one who has the right to be proud is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the only one. He is the glorious, He is the mighty. And we, brothers and sisters, should always remember our base origins. Let us remember what we have come from. Let us remember that we came from a sperm and an egg, a despicable fluid, as the Quran mentions it. We came from dust. Those are our origins. We were children. We couldn't even feed ourselves. We couldn't even wash ourselves. Our mothers had to do that for us. That is the origin. And what is our end? Our end is the grave. We came from dust and we will go back to dust. What is there for us to be mighty about? What is there for us to be haughty about? No, rather, we should be humble. And there are many quotations we can find about humility. And we find that really, that humility is considered to be the fountain and the foundation of all other virtues. According to St. Augustine, he says that humility is the foundation of all virtues. Hence, in the soul in which this virtue does not exist, there cannot be any other virtue except by mere appearance. This is how important that humility is. And even when we look at the world around us, when we see Allah's creation, its power, how small and how insignificant we are before the destructive power of a storm or a tsunami or an earthquake, how inadequate we are, how feeble we are, my brothers and sisters, let us remember our humble origins. And there is a saying of Confucius that humility is the solid foundation of all virtues. Humility is the solid foundation of all virtues. There are many other sayings like that. Humility is the root, mother, nurse, foundation, and bond of all virtues. That is one Christian writer. And also James Matthew Barry, he says, life is a long lesson in humility. So my brothers and sisters, let us try to develop within ourselves this quality of humility. Number one, let us remember our origins, how humble our origins are. Number two, let us remember that everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, remind yourself of your failures, of your imperfections, of your shortcomings. Then when these things happen in our life, when there are failures, when there are mistakes, when there are shortcomings, then we will benefit from those things. And then finally, of course, we should make supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always remembering Him, asking Him, because when we call upon Allah, that is an expression of our need and our dependence and our reliance for Him, the Exalted, the Mighty, the Wise. So my dear brothers and sisters, I invite you to embrace humility, to remember how much we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to be very, very far from pride and arrogance, which is so destructive. Do not be like Shaitan, who when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him and the angels to bow down before Adam, he was proud and he refused. So what did all his worship of Allah benefit him? It is even said that he was the one who was in charge of the angels. He was their leader in worship. Yet, when Allah ordered him, he disobeyed. This is pride. And this pride is surely and most definitely a path to destruction in this life and to destruction in the life to come. So my dear brothers and sisters, please take your time, take the opportunity to try and apply this knowledge in your life. Until next week, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.